Hello, I'm ApiXClickout and welcome back to another Update Aquatic video. Today we're talking about the Minecraft Bedrock version of the Update Aquatic because it either has an exclusive feature or a currently exclusive feature which is really weird, really wacky and looks like it comes from a mod but actually has quite a few very bizarre applications because as of the Update Aquatic, as of 1.2.14.2 on the Bedrock version, you can now officially tie leads to boats. So again, this looks like some weird add-on or something like that, but it actually works. It actually has quite a few bizarre applications and I wanted to talk about how it works and why in this video, because it's a little bit counterintuitive and a little bit interesting in certain situations. So hopefully you all enjoy it. Like if you do like it, because it helps out the channel a lot. Let's know you do like this tutorials, but let's get straight into explaining exactly how this does work. We have a couple of friends of me here today to explain it, because with players involved, everything gets really different. But basically, you can now tie leads to boats. It's as simple as, you know, clicking on the boat just like this, and then putting, so as you can see, grab a boat, put a lead in it, and now we have the boat which is tied to the lead. And as you can see, we can move around the boat if there is nothing in it, and it's going to work just fine. And we can also then, if we want to, tie the lead to a fence. As you can see, I've done it just here, and it's a wonderful thing you can do. However, if you, you'll notice how if you actually put a lead on something else, if you put it on someone else's boat, it won't affect that boat. So for instance, if I get my boat on a lead right here, as you can see, I can move the boat as far as I want to, and there's no effect on the game if I try. However, the moment I get out of the boat and the lead affect each other. And if this guy, he's going to go too far in a little bit, he's going to break the lead because he's going to go too far away from it, and the boat is going to stretch. So yeah, lead physics work on boats now, but they don't work on boats with players in. It's a really bizarre kind of way for this to do things, because as you can see, I can push a boat as far as I want to with nothing in there, but it's just going to stretch and pull back eventually. But if I, as soon as I get in the boat, it works. And as soon as one of these two people get in the boat, it's going to work as well. So if I want to, I can push this guy away and it's going to break the lead that his boat is on. So it's really, really bizarre in that measure. But also, if we take the lead off here and we grab the lead on just myself, so I grab a lead, and then I grab these, in fact, let's get three leads for three boats. Then we hop in the fourth boat ourselves. As you can see, I'm going to try and drag all three of these people. And despite the fact that there's three boats all kind of equal, none of the boats are moving the same way. You can see how the lead on that guy broke, and if I go this way, the lead on him broke too, because people in boats cannot be moved by leads. Leads only work for empty boats and boats with mobs in. So I assume this is either a balancing change, or it's one they just, technically decided, like, it's just too much hassle or something like that. But I assume the benefit is, like, okay, if you're playing PvP, you don't want someone to lead your boat and then drag you away, so it kind of makes some sense. But it's also super bizarre that, boat physics work with leads perfectly fine until a human gets in there. And they work with anything else, by the way. As you can see, he can drag a boat around too. Boats and people work just fine, but you can't drag a person in a boat. And that's a cool little thing, so now you understand that. But let's talk about what the applications of this are then, because if you can't drag people around, then what's the point? Because the big benefit, in my opinion, was going to be like, what if we could get, like, two people in one boat, two people in another, and have one person drag the entire fleet? That would be cool, right? But that doesn't actually work as of this update. Instead, the benefits of this are for two purposes. First of all, moving boats on land. So this is one that, honestly, because if you've ever ridden a boat on land, it's super frustrating. You go at this speed, like a block every 2 seconds or something. It's very, very frustrating, but you can actually drag boats along land a little bit faster. So as you can see, much faster right here. I assume that's, like, a little bit glitchy. And also, if you drag boats over a cliff or something, so as you can see, this isn't a cliff, it's like two blocks. But if a boat goes through the air, it goes much faster. We can drag it all the way, and you can do some crazy physics like that, so you can launch boats, which is nice. But as well as that, you can also, have boats with other stuff in, and you can tie them together. So kind of in the same way that llama packs will allow you to drag a lot of, food, you can do the same thing if you want with boats. So we drag, as you can see, here I have myself six polar bears in three boats, and then a sheep in, a polar bear got in this one. So six polar bear in three boats, and then a sheep and a polar bear. So we have eight mobs we want to take with me from one place to another. All I have to do is put a lead on each of these, which I'm going to do right now, as you can see. So, and then we can drag them around with us. So yeah, for some reason, okay, it seems like a lot of the boats are giving me difficulties. There we go. But we can drag leads onto each of the boats individually if we try. There we go. Again, there's a little bit of a weird quirkiness in how it works right now. But then we can drag all these mobs with us if we want to. So, yeah, have you ever wanted to go somewhere with a bunch of mobs? Then guess what? As of this update, you can now do that. It looks really, really silly in my opinion, but it is something you can totally do. And I absolutely love it. So, yeah, what is the point of having boats and leads? I think it's mostly an experimental feature. Someone on the Bedrock team was just like, why not? And the applications of it are potentially really valuable. Again, it's not useful for player versus player. It's mostly a single player feature. In multiplayer, you can't interact with each other's leads anyway, but if you are playing in single player, then one, it's useful for dragging animals around, two, it's useful for going along land, and then three, I mentioned this at the start, but, like, only very briefly. So, by the way, you have to be careful with your speed on this. But I mentioned this at the start, but only very briefly. You can also use it to tie boats to a dock. Because right now, if you tie boats to a dock and then something happens, they can be moved. But if we go back to the dock, so let's just In fact, let's tie all three of these mobs here. As you can see, we can now leave these boats, as well as their inhabitants, tied to the dock just fine. Although one of the strings broke. But whatever, you can see, you can leave your boats tied there, and then the boat won't be able to get away. There's no way to... Okay, well... ignoring the fact that that kind of broke right there, you can see how you can tie a boat to a dock, and now there's like a true way to have a dock. Because we've always had docks made of like, you know, soul sand and stuff like that, stop them breaking. But now you can truly leave a boat tied somewhere, and then you... It's like an anchor in a ship, right? And yeah, that's a cool thing you can do in this update. I think it's really interesting, and I think the possibilities are going to go much higher, and potentially if they make it so it works with players, we get some crazy possibilities. But right now, it's a single player feature with a lot of bizarre applications, and I'd love to know what you think it's best for in the comments down below. But here is your tutorial on how it works, especially involving players, because it's a little bit strange and counterintuitive. So like this if you like it, because it helps out the channel a lot. Let's know you do like the updated aquatic tutorials, share if you really liked it, and subscribe if you're around here, because I'll be making lots more videos about all the new updated aquatic features. Remember, we've still got, you know, this update by itself, this one beta was huge, but I've got all the secrets in it as well, so you know it's huge, and then there's lots of huge secret features, and then as well as that, we're still seeing dolphins, we're still seeing brand new water in the next week's beta. We've got lots of huge things coming, and make sure you stay subscribed, stay up to date with all of them. I'm super excited right now. I woke up today and I was like, you know, I have to play with those boats, I have to work them out, and it's been a while since I've had like that have to, you know, explore for feature feeling. So yeah, if you want to see where it takes me in the future, subscribing is the best way to see those. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye.